Thank you for joining us.
Woo-hoo!
I'm Perry, and that strange noise you just heard was Liza, coming to you from wherever the heck they are right now.
I'm in my room.
And tonight, we will be providing you with a special service, perhaps the most important play you have ever had the pleasure to witness.
More useful than Hamlet?
Slightly. I mean, who can identify with being a prince and having the ghost of their dead father put him on bloody revenge?
It certainly helped me through my recent family situation.
But can Hamlet teach you how to find toilet paper?
No.
Case closed.
Will this play show people how to get toilet paper?
No, but it will do everything else.
Where we're going, we won't need toilet paper.
I don't know about that. Without much further ado, it is time to present 10 ways to survive life in quarantine. Can we get a cool sound effect for that?
We can try.
That's all we're doing tonight. Behold, our show. Oh, 10 ways to survive life in quarantine. Method 1. Fall in love with inanimate objects.
A great way to maintain sanity during these difficult times is to have a complicated relationship with an object. Let's see how Peter is doing.
Yes, I'm here, and I'm negotiating quarantine very well. In fact, I prefer it because I get to spend time with my new best friend, Spaulding. Say hello, Spaulding. Normally he talks. It's just that when he gets in front of the camera, he clams up. And that's fine. It's fine. You know, it's not like we made an agreement to both do the talking. But it's fine. I'm not mad. Oh, now you want to say something? Oh, but just to me. If it's so important, Spaulding, why not say it to everybody else? Oh. Well, that's how we're gonna do this. You're gonna make me look crazy in front of all my friends? Anyways. Me and Spaulding have been getting along for the most part. I mean, sometimes we take walks. You know, we go from the bed to the closet and get this back to the bed. I know. And another thing, and this is super fun. We just sit down and stare into each other's eyes like this. It's magical. You're so beautiful, Spaulding. Normally, he says it back. It's okay. It's just nice to have the validation of one's feelings. But I guess he's just playing hard to get. It doesn't hurt. Oh. What? Huh? I'm not good enough for you? Oh, that's how you want to play this? Is that what you want me to say? You know what? I don't need you. I have other friends. Meet Pen. Pen loves me for me. I've been in love with Pen the whole time.
See, he's improving.
He's doing a lot better. Let's check in on Brynn.
Hello, everyone. I know what you're thinking. What's her secret? She looks amazing. Well, I do thank you. There's a special new person in my life, and his name is Sir Lamp from the Kingdom of Lamps. He's a prince. You're probably wondering how a prince from the Kingdom of Lamps came to be in my room. Well, some things are just like a fairy tale, right? I just sat here like a fairy princess waiting for a prince to rescue me. And he did. although we're now quarantined together and he can't leave. But that's all right. You light up my life. You light up my room. You let me read when it's dark. You light up my day, even when I don't need you to. Not everyone has a special love like ours. Most nights, we just read poetry. Actually, Sir Liam can't read or speak, but that makes him the perfect boyfriend because he's such a great listener. So much listening. You're probably jealous right now, but that's all right. We don't care. Our love will shine brightly. Shh, my love. Shh.
That seems like a healthy relationship.
Whoa, now I want to date Sir Lamp.
He's not very bright.
Those are the best kind.
And last, Lou is going to share how his inanimate object is getting through him through his quarantine.
Hello, is this thing on? Hello? Oh, yes. Hello, it is me, Lou. You might not remember my name from school because I was always the one sitting in the back or getting stuff in the backpack since we don't have lockers anymore or sitting out in gym class since I didn't like the outfits. I've got a special message here for all the ladies. I know that I wasn't on your radar. I know that you'd rather fall for Bryce, the quarterback of the water polo horse team or whatever. And yes, he's super attractive and nice and talented and all that, but I have something that Bryce doesn't have. Oh yeah, look at that. This is the real deal, ladies. 4-ply. Count them. This isn't your generic grocery store off-brand toilet paper that's the last thing on the shelf. Oh no, this is pure white gold. This feels like a cloud, or possibly a Pomeranian, or even a cloud of Pomeranian puppies. You know what I'm talking about. And it could all be yours. I mean, this even had a picture of a baby on it. Why do they put pictures of babies on toilet paper? No baby's using toilet paper. At least no baby I've ever met. Unless they're implying that it feels like a baby, which would be very weird. Anyways, where was I? Well, I mean, am I right? I will be taking applications for new best friend after the show. In the meantime, dare to dream. Dare to dream.
I'll be your friend.
Shh. It's okay. It's over.
I miss you, 4-ply. I miss you so much.
And it's time for our second method. Method 2, performing your own musicals with your pets.
That's right. Your co-stars are right in your house. Use them. And they don't need pay except with treats.
Ella shows us how it's done.
Hey there. I'm Ella, and welcome to the most realistic production of Cats ever. This is McCavity, the mystery cat. And that one is trying to break out of my room. Come to mama, room, gender. Ow! He's shy. I asked my mom if we could get 16 extra cats for the show, and she got in her car and drove away, and I haven't seen her since. I'm guessing she went to get more cats, but that was 3 days ago, so I'm beginning to wonder. Also, if you'd like to bring cats to my house, that would be amazing. Just drop them off in crates on my front doorstep, and they will be loved and hugged and thrust into starring roles of this production. As anyone knows, Cats is the story of the Jellicle Cats. These guys. Once every blue moon, the Jellicle Cats get together to enact a live cat sacrifice of one of the cats to the underworld. And the other ones just go on their way for no reason at all. And they sing and dance. Dance for Mama. Dance. They're learning. Slowly. This is coming together. I only need a few more months and many, many more cats. Memory. All alone in my room now. I can dream of the old days. We could go outside then. I remember the time I didn't like going to school. Let the memory live again. Meow, 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 meow. Meow, meow, meow.
I think that was better than the movie.
Definitely.
But Cats isn't the only musical you can do from your own room. Beautiful.
I want pets in all the plays from now on.
You might just get your wish.
Hello, and welcome to my 2 minute, one person, one bunny production of Beauty and the Beast. Timer's ready. Lulu, ready? And go. Lights up on a provincial town in France.
Oh, look. It's Belle.
She's so pretty. But she's so peculiar.
Oh, look, it's my daughter, Belle.
Papa, why don't I fit in here?
Because you can read, and no one else in this town can read.
Oh, that makes sense.
Well, I'm off to wander in the woods with a ridiculous invention.
All right. Isn't that dangerous?
Oh, well, what could hurt me besides a pack of wolves and a monster living in a curse in a castle?
Okay.
Well, bye, Belle. Oh, no! It's a monster living in a curse in a castle! Ah! Oh, skipping forward. Gaston comes in and he's like, I eat a lot of eggs, marry me, Belle. And she's like, heck no, you're stupid. And then somehow realizes that her father's captured. So she wanders into the woods.
Grr, grr.
Ah!
Grr yourself, stupid walls.
Oh, you are the most beautiful maiden I've ever seen. I wonder if you'll look past appearances, since I obviously can't.
Well,
wake up, lady. Wake up.
And then Beast is like, you can't leave. Even though Belle wanted to escape,
then... Here, you like books, right? I've got books, lots of them. You can read them. Be our guest, be our guest, put our service to the test. It's working! She loves me for treats! True love at last! This is basically Stockholm Syndrome, but I love you anyway!
Kiss!
Kiss me! And now I'm an extremely attractive man since you've learned to look past appearances. And happy ending!
I didn't think he was gonna make it.
The key to Belle's heart was through her stomach with treats.
Makes sense.
And now it's time for method 3.
A big problem is keeping yourself occupied.
How do you spend the time if not planning revenge?
Revenge on who?
You'll find out.
Jolene has some answers for us in our third method, fun with scissors, or so much craft.
Welcome, friends. I'm Jolene, and I'm here to show a wonderful way to spend your time in isolation. One thing I do to manage stress in these, let's face it, stressful conditions. Little joke there. I know it wasn't a great joke or anything, but sometimes it's the little jokes that aren't funny. That's where the true humor lies. So, I like to do origami, which is a traditional Japanese art or technique of folding paper into a variety of decorative or representational forms, such as animals or flowers. I learned that from the internet. I find origami soothing, so let's learn how to make a paper crane, shall we? First up, grab a piece of paper. Next, fold it. Then, fold it again, and once more, just for fun. So much fun. Just an amazing amount of fun. And then you... and I think it goes like this. Whoops. Not like that. That was a boo-boo. That was a terrible boo-boo. Just an awful mistake made by a person who is failing at this very soothing task. And... nope. Not that way. Not that way either. Not that way. Does it look like a crane? It's a paper crane, right? It's a soothing origami crane, and I love doing it. I love making it. I love it so much. Actually, that part was soothing.
I feel like I learned something.
I learned not to go over to Jolene's house.
There's no problem with that one.
Let's see what Pascal's up to.
Oh. All right. Hi, everybody. Pascal here, and I'm learning all kinds of new things in quarantine, like how to hide from the rest of my family. And the best place to go is here, in the garage. And today, I'll be showing you how to make a birdhouse. A birdhouse. That's right. I know what you're thinking. Why did the birds need houses, Pascal? Did they build nests for themselves? Aren't you just encouraging the birds to be lazy and not do their own work by providing them subsidized housing? Think about it. You're not building a squirrel house. I don't see anyone building a deer house out there. Those animals have to live outside like animals. And suddenly, you're privileging birds over other animals? What the heck are you doing?
You know, you actually have some pretty good points there. I mean, do the birds really need our help? Those dudes can fly. All the other animals can't fly. They have to walk on the ground like idiots. And we're making stuff for birds? Birds poop on your head. Do other animals poop on your head? No. Does a deer just come out of the woods, climb up the side of your house, lean over your gutter, and poop on your head? No. Deer don't do that. Not to mention the fact that birds are free. Right? They can fly anywhere. It's like they're super beings and I'm just stuck to the crust of an earth like a fool. They're not in quarantine. They're not worried about getting the stupid virus. They're basically running the show right now. Everywhere I look outside is birds. No people, birds are in charge. And I'm supposed to use my time to make them a nest? I'm supposed to make something for a lazy, ignorant bird that can't even figure out how to make his own nest? No! No more! I will not make a birdhouse today. Yeah, so I do my best thinking in the garage.
It's nice to have a hobby.
Venting is a great hobby.
My favorite.
Maybe one of our people can actually create a craft. Let's check on Angelina.
Hi, friends. It's Angela here with a wonderful painting lesson for all of you. I find that creating art is such a soothing way to exercise my imagination. Just so nice. So lovely. So nice. Okay then. First thing, you take your happy little paintbrush and we try to think of something to paint. Let's try to think happy thoughts, shall we? Try real hard. I'm going to start with a tree. So you take a bit of brown, and the little dab goes right here. Just a little dab right here. Happy, happy, happy. This tree has seen some life. It's in a forest. Maybe there's a brown squirrel on this tree that we can't see. And this tree has some leaves. So I dip my paintbrush in water and go for some green. That's the color of leaves in my world. Might not be on your world. You might live on Mars. There aren't any trees on Mars, but there could be, but there aren't. You're living in a crazy world. This is going so well. Almost looks like a child made this. That's okay. Children make wonderful things, but they are very bad painters. Just awful. Oh, okay, look, this is not a happy tree. Now it's a happy tree. And what else with our tree? How about an animal? So I wash off the green, the black here, and I'm looking for a color. How about brown? I'm going to paint a happy little moose here. Doo-doo. Oh yes, this moose is in the forest. Only one tree, I guess that's not a forest, but he is a happy little moose, and we know that because... he is smiling! Could be rabies. Sometimes there's rabies in woods. But this is a happy moose, and he's not gonna bite you. Very realistic. And here is the meteor coming to destroy everything. It's a happy meteor. I find painting so soothing. Here comes the meteor. Watch out, Moose. You're not gonna make it. Neither are you, Tree. Not so happy are you now, huh? But, plot twist, the Moose has a shield. And look at this. Eat it, Meteor. But wait, the Meteor has a cannon with him, and I'm being told we're out of time. So remember, painting is soothing, and it really can help.
The imagination is a terrible thing.
To waste?
Nope, just a terrible thing. Let's see what else we have.
Method 4. I'm good at sports now, and no one can stop me.
Remember when you were a child, and you thought you were good at things?
Yeah.
And then you encountered other children, and you realized you were terrible at those things?
Yes.
Well, now, without competition, you can be the athlete you always had the delusion of being.
For those of you just tuning in now, we've got a barn burner. The Libertyville Monarchs, led by the All-Conference Tash Johnson, are down by 2 to the Motorville Motorheads. It has been a stunning display of athleticism from Johnson, who scored a season-high 78 points, grabbed 42 rebounds, and recorded 27 blocks. I've never seen anything like it. I haven't seen anything like it either, Dave. We are witnessing the birth of a new basketball god. This is like the first time I saw LeBron James play, except so much better than that. He is already the greatest basketball player that has ever lived, or ever will live, or will ever live in alternate dimensions. And here we go. Johnson inbounds to Johnson. He spins. Oh my goodness, the moves on display are so magical. They're so magical. He goes through the legs, and then through the legs, and then over the head of the defender. He launches from long distance, just off the rim. He grabs the rebound. He puts it up. Just off the rim again. He grabs the rebound again. No one can stop him. The clock is counting down. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. And a foul. And we're just going to have to assume he makes the free throw. The Monarchs have won. The crowd goes wild, even though it's social distance at 6 feet apart from each other. They're losing their minds. They're storming their court. This is the greatest moment in basketball history. I can't believe what I've just seen. And they're carrying him off the court. Yeah, wow.
I didn't think he was going to pull that out.
I thought the Motorheads had that one.
They totally blew it.
I lost a lot of money on that.
And there are other imaginary sports, too.
Here we are at the World Solitaire Championships. As always, the young challenger, Benoit, has cut a swath of destruction through the field. Imperturbable and so exceptionally handsome, he's had an answer for everything the cards have thrown at him. Now it comes down to this, the final table. And here comes the prize money. Just over $114 billion. Enough for Benoit to ride his ticket anywhere, if he can only keep it together in this final, most intense hand of solitaire. And the first cards are coming face down as always. Brilliant form, really. I mean, the kind of spectacular card placement we've been seeing all tournament. Oh, and here we go. You've got the tension here with a knife. Like, a really sharp knife. Also an imaginary knife. You can really start to see the stress showing up in Benoit's face. Oh, he can't like that. That is not a good sign for Benoit. Oh, he's in trouble now. This is a bloodbath. I've never seen anyone go so deep with just 2 cards. Oh, he's reaching into his steely core for whatever reserves of sanity and strength he has left. 1, 2, 3. I can't take it. I can't take it. Look at all those cards. All those glorious, glorious cards. It's over. I don't see any way for him to win. Might as well pack up his bags and go home. But wait, he's using the tried and true method of solitaire players everywhere, by cheating when no one is looking. Has anyone seen him cheat? No. Therefore, it's legal. And that's it. Benoit has won the championships.
Woo! I'm going to Disneyland when it reopens at some point in the future. I'm also going to stay 6 feet away from anybody there, so I'm probably not going to go. But I'm going to think about it. Woo!
I'm excellent at solitaire when no one is looking, too.
You're only cheating yourself.
That's why I win.
And finally, the oldest sport, boxing.
This is not a comeback. I'm not coming back from being down. I am the greatest. I'll make a prediction about my upcoming fight. In the 7th round, I'm going to knock out my opponent. That's right. You were the first. 7th round. 4th minute. Maybe 20 or 21st second. My opponent, who's afraid of these fists of fury, will do okay for the first 3 rounds. But that's only because I will be wearing this very heavy coat that will stop my energy for those 3 rounds. It will be a huge mistake to wear this coat, but I'm going to do it anyway, because I cannot learn from my mistakes. I will not take questions. Your questions are unworthy of my greatness. Instead, I will once again make a prediction about my upcoming fight. In the 4th round, I'm going to hug my opponent. A lot. So many hugs. He can't even imagine how many times he's about to get hugged. Anytime he comes close, I'll wrap my arms around him like this and say, "Come to Papa Bear!" And we'll embrace and have a moment of tenderness together. By the end of the 4th round, our relationship has evolved to the point where we trust each other. And when we hug in the 5th round, we share deep personal secrets that we can never say in public. I never got enough love from my father. I have a deep, abiding fear of lettuce. In the 6th round, we are untamed. We are glorious. And when we hug again, the ref has to pull us apart because we never want to be separated. Home is my embrace. Home is our friendship. Home is our love. And in the 7th round, I'm going to knock him out. That's how our fight goes.
Bold predictions.
They're probably just as accurate as any other pre-fight declarations.
Indeed they are.
But now we're on to method 5.
The plays of William Shakespeare.
That's Shakespeare.
No, you heard me.
Julius Caesar, Act 3, Scene 1. The Ides of March are come. But I'm as constant as the northern star. The skies are painted with unnumbered sparks. They're all fire, and every over doth shine. But there's one in all doth hold his place. So in the world, 'tis furnished well with bears and other stuffed animals. And stuffed animals are but stuffing, and some fell. Yet in the number, I do know, but one, that unassailable, holds on his rank. Unshaked emotion, in that I am he. O sea spare, hence, wilt thou lift up Olympus? Great sea spear! Doth not Brutus bootless kneel? Speak hands for me! Ah! Oh no, I'm being stabbed! Ah! So many stabbings! This is terrible! Oh, I loved you all! Ah! Et tu brut? Then fall, sea spear! Bleh! Liberty! Freedom! Tyranny is dead! Woo! Heck yes! This is a good day! Yee-haw! Now what?
Those bears should have thought that through better.
Thinking ahead is not really a staple of Shakespeare characters. Or stuffed animals. Like this scene.
Should I play the Roman fool and die on my own sword, whilst I see life, the gashes do better upon them? Macbeth, turn, hellhound, turn. Macduck, of all ducks else I have avoided thee, but get thee back. My soul is too much charged with blood of thine already. I have no words. My voice is my sword. Thou losest labor, I bear a charmed life, which must not yield to one of woman born. Despair thy charm, and let the angel whom thou still hast served tell thee, Macduck was born from a duck! Oh no, shoot.
That's right, sucker.
Booyah. Tomorrow, and tomorrow, and tomorrow. What part of booyah didn't you understand?
Now what?
But it's not just terrible tragedies that are fun to perform with stuffed animals.
No, wait. It is terrible tragedies that are the most fun to perform with stuffed animals.
How about a terrible tragedy where everyone dies?
Just to catch everyone up, Froggy has killed Hootlet's father and then married Queen Fortune. Hootlet's father showed up and told Hootlet, "Hey, I was killed and you need to go out there and revenge my death." Hootlet was like, "That's crazy, man, but sure, Dad." And then Hootlet killed Beard, his father, for no reason. So now Beard is like, "Hey, man, you killed my dad. I liked my dad." And Hootlet was like, "I don't care. My dad's too." And then Hootlet's girlfriend killed herself because Hootlet was mean. And now Hootlet and Beardus are about to duel. Except Froggus has poisoned the Leerup's blade, and he's also poisoned the cup too in case Hootlet was thirsty. Simple. "Come, Beardus. Come, my lord." 1. Nope. Judgment. A hit. A palatable hit. Told ya. Didn't count. You missed me, dude. He just said a hit. A palatable hit. I didn't hear that. He said it. He totally said it. 1. Oh, come on. I'm thirsty. No. Ack. Poison. Shoot. I'm dead. Arg. Oh, villainy. Seek it out. It is here, Hootlet. Hootlet, thou art slain. The treacherous instrument is in thy hand, unbated and envenomed. The king. The king's to blame. The point. Envenomed too. Then, venom to do the work. Ah, dang it. The rest is silence. And then pretty much everyone else dies.
Well done. Greatest play ever.
I think we've had enough senseless death, though.
And now, 5 more. Let's get into it. Sound effect, please.
Oh, no. We're doing the sound effect again.
We are doing the sound effect again. Here we go. The last 5 ways to survive life in a quarantine.
Method 6. Catch up on your studies.
Fun.
Super fun.
Hi, everybody. I'm Allison, and I'm here to help you. This has been a stressful time for everyone, but I think the best way to forget about everything is to put your nose down and really focus on school right now. I am, and I love it. I'm learning so much. Yes, I have 3 little sisters that are driving me crazy, but guess what? I can lock and bolt my door and booby trap the hallway so they can't get at me. Oh, I just put on some headphones, dive into trigonometry, and ignore their little screams. Numbers are my friends now. Speaking of friends, I'm actually running a special on Math Help right now. If you need someone to do your math homework, just email me and I will do it. Because I do not want to do anything else. It's math, 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 math all day here. Ha ha ha. So happy. Speaking of math, I'm only charging $3.55 per assignment. Then I email the assignments back to you. You put your own name on it and turn it in as your own work. I offer both grades as well. 10 assignments for $32, which is a savings of 10.94%. Again, math, I love it. Also, May is my special algebra sale. 5% off all algebra homework. Look for more. Hello? You're saying it's illegal and I shouldn't be talking about it online? Oh. Okay. I did not realize that selling my math homework was illegal. This changes my business plan significantly. Luckily, I've been studying economics, so I know when something is illegal, it becomes a lot more expensive. Therefore, my rates have changed. $22 per assignment. I will be using the extra revenue to hire goons who will be enforcing collection policies. They will be breaking your legs in a responsible manner. This is so fun! Seriously, buy now you still can. I am your only hope. Without me, you are doomed. You won't regret this.
It's good to see someone of our students are putting their minds to brilliant criminality.
It's really the American way.
But maybe there's someone out there who is really studying well.
Hey, thanks, guys. My name is Torrance, and I'm here to show you exactly how great this learning has been for me. Because it's been a thing. It has definitely been a thing. So the first thing I do is I log into my email. And right now my computer's on speaking terms with other computers, so that's cool. That's alright. Because I can log into access the help page that the district has made. Which is currently offline, which is fine, so I can't get to that. I've also forgot my password, so I can't get a new password sent to me because there are a lot of requests for new passwords or something. I don't know, there's only so much internet, I guess, and it doesn't reach my house. That's cool, that's fine, I'm working through it. Mostly I'm just trying to imagine what my teachers are trying to teach me right now, since I can't log into anything or get anything to work or get anyone to help me or screen loud enough so that rescue workers can find me. So anyway, my teachers are not assigning homework, at least my imaginary teachers aren't, because they are very respectful of my time and want to make sure that I have the most fun quarantine possible. But I keep trying, kind of a little bit, you know, just making the effort every day for a good 5 or 6 minutes. And then calling it. There's no use bashing your head into a wall over and over again, right? At some point, you just have to assume that learning is not for you. To be honest, learning was not for me before this anyway, so... I guess my teachers are not surprised I'm not able to log in. Although, my imaginary teachers are super chill about it. They're really impressed. Ah, shoot, my connection's screwing up.
My heart just grew 3 sizes watching that.
These children are our future.
Terrifying.
Hi everyone, Jules here, and I am loving life. Why, do you ask? Because just before we got sent home, my English teacher assigned the greatest book in the history of everything. That's right. Dun, dun, dun! That's a drum roll. It's The Scarlet Letter by Nathaniel Hawthorne. Reading this book, it's like all the feels, you know? So many feels. I've read it 7 times now, and I almost understand it. It's got everything. A main character who gets rocks thrown at her for no reason, an evil child that speaks in tongues, an unhappy ending where the main character dies. It's fabulous. This book told me that every chance I had at happiness is doomed to be squashed by the patriarchy. And I am thankful for the heads up. Thanks, Scarlet Letter. I was just about to dream things. Moral of the story, don't be a lady. They're just made for trouble. Am I right, fellas? And check out my Scarlet Letter themed clothing. A is for awesome. I mean, not in the book. But I think I deserve an A. Again, not in the way of the book. In the way of a grade. And also, fun hats! You can almost see where it restricts my eye movement like a horse with blinders. So I can be focused on the straight and narrow. Oh boy, this was the best choice my English teacher has ever made. I am so happy with her reading choices for us. I can't wait to write a paper on this. Maybe even a 5-paragraph essay with topic sentences and correct grammar and punctuation. That will be so fun. I can't wait. Yay!
I love the idea of teachers enforcing homework through constant surveillance.
They are watching you.
Good thing the school district invested in that fleet of silent drones.
Which brings us to method 7.
Get really involved in the lives of squirrels outside your window.
With limited options for television these days, you can watch The Wild Kingdom outside.
Shh! Don't ruin it, okay? Hold on. Darn it! They're still not back yet. But they could be back any minute now. So, let's go over here. And let me tell you about the latest updates with Kim and Connie the squirrels. It has been off the charts lately. So much is happening. I'm watching and I'm like, oh my gosh, I shouldn't even be seeing this, you know? It is so intense. Let me show you my notes. Day one. They are so beautiful. Perfection with those soft puppy tails and little noses. They don't have a care in the world. Such a beautiful, happy home. Kanye goes out and gets the acorns and gives them to Kim. She loves him so much. Day two. When Kanye was out today gathering acorns, a new squirrel appeared. Stanley. Oof. He's sleek and skinny like a sewer rat. I hate him. No, those were Connie's acorns. He found those and gave them to Kim, but she handed them over to Stanley. Later, Connie comes home, and where are the acorns? Oh, Kim ate them all, I guess. You furry cow. But Connie doesn't know what's going on, so he goes back out, because that's the kind of squirrel he is. He knows nothing. Day 8. Kim went out for acorns today and Kanye stayed back. So Stanley arrives and it is on, y'all. It's like a school MMA up in that tree. Get him, Kanye. Get that thieving rat. Stanley will not be back. Mark my words. Day 9. Stanley is back. Kim gave him acorns again. They are trash. They are so much trash. Day 12. Connie is the king of trash. Kim went out today and two red squirrels showed up, Bridget and Jennifer. And Connie was all about them. I have seen squirrels do things that I didn't even know squirrels did. I can't even with them. No wonder Kim was giving the nuts to Stanley. Stanley is such a prince. Day 15. Milo arrived today. Milo is one sweet looking squirrel, but they are falling for his nonsense. Day 17. I can't even with any of them, but I'm still Team Kim till I die. And then, oh, who's this bunny sniffing around? Oh, this will not end well.
It's not just squirrels that have drama.
I never thought she was going to make it. It was impossible. The tree branch is probably 20 feet from my window. There's simply limits to what can be done. And this was beyond. I was standing here when I saw her. She was getting ready. And I was like, you'll never make it. Turn back. For Pete's sake, stop what you're doing. This is madness. She didn't listen. Probably because she doesn't speak English. Or hear things maybe I don't know. There's no way a medium-sized spider can make a web 20 feet across. What are you trying to catch, idiot? Birds? But I tell you something, people out there. She leapt from that branch with a filament of silk coming out her backside, and she just caught the breeze and so soared to my window. She made it. I was still skeptical. Sure, you make it across once, but a web requires you to make many, many trips. So there's no way you're going to be able to make it back to the tree. Give up. You're doomed. You'll never make it. Friends? She launched herself again and again. She made it to the tree. I was stunned. Was this the greatest spider athlete in the history of the world? Am I watching the Michael Jordan of spiders? Is she not bound by the laws of physics? And yeah, I realize I'm using female pronouns here for the spider, but I'm pretty sure she was a lady since all the boys get eaten immediately after mating. You learned something. I watched for 7 hours as that spider beat the odds, strand after strand after strand. And I thought to myself, she didn't listen to the naysayers. She didn't care what the crowd was saying. She knew what she was capable of. And that's a lesson to all of us out here. Don't let yourself be afraid. If you can dream it, you can do it. If you believe, you can build a deadly trap 2,000 times your body weight and murder as much life as possible. You can do that. Then later a bird flew through and destroyed the whole thing, so I'm not sure what that means.
I learned that nature is not boring.
So much for short attention spans.
But if you're looking for a little more action.
Ladies and gentlemen, this stray cat fight is scheduled for a bunch of rounds until one of the cats runs off or an owner comes out to stop it. Fighting out of the bush on that side of my house, wearing the tabby coat, it's the notch-eared master of disaster, the ferocious feline, the outdoor cat of outdoor splat, Mongo the Fuzzball! And fighting off the porch on that side of my house, wearing the gray coat with black stripes, it's the menace of the midway, the scourge of squirrels, the yowler to fowler, Buttons! Ding, ding, ding! And out they come. Buttons is moving sideways. He has his butt way in the air to appear bigger than he is. Oh, and he's yowling now. Buttons has a fearsome yowl. Mongo is staying put. Mongo's butt's in the air, too. His tail's up. Who will strike first? And it's Buttons jumping in with two claws out. And Mongo's in the air. Mongo's gone vertical. He's 3 feet in the air, and he appears to be running sideways while in the air. How's that possible? This is some kung fu now. And they back off. The judges scored that exchange in favor of Buttons 2-1. And Buttons is in again. He's in again, and he's all over Mongo. Mongo rears back. He's on his back now. He's fighting with his back claws. He's trying to break Buttons in the stomach. And Buttons is hit. Buttons is hit. I repeat, Buttons has taken a claw to the stomach. My heart is beating so fast right now, I'm probably having a heart attack. But I will stay at my post to announce this cat fight. And Mongo is on the attack. This is the end game, folks. This is the end game. And they appear to be walking away from each other. They're walking away. This appears to be a draw. We have a split decision. Stay tuned for the rematch.
Rigged.
Totally rigged. Buttons tested positive for catnip.
I knew it.
And now we come to the most popular survival method.
Number 8. Sleep, live in pajamas, eat chocolate, binge watch shows.
Or the weekend is now your life.
Greetings, followers. It's I, Lynn, your style giver. I know that you've been anxiously awaiting my special quarantine fashion looks, and I want to let you know that you are all in my heart, all of you. I could not be the influencer I am without your devoted and creepy support. Seriously, some of you need to get a life, but that's what I'm here for, to have a life for you, to show you the kind of life a really attractive person has. It's so much better than yours. I don't mind your jealousy. I thrive on it. I am broadcasting today from my couch, which is made of some type of fabric and was bought at an exclusive store for couches. It's so exclusive that they probably wouldn't even let you in. It's also likely closed at the moment, but still. When I feel this couch, I know that it's special and beautiful, like me, and not like you. Also with me today is this designer blanket and these designer chocolates and designer chips. Perfect for visiting, lounging, and this smoking snacking. Today I'm resplendent in Star Wars Chewbacca pajamas, which I have worn for the last 11 days. This particular set of pajamas was made by people in the pajama industry. I like to imagine them as they do whatever they do to make pajamas. They were hoping that someone like me would wear them someday. It's probably their dream. They don't have big dreams, most likely. I hope that an influencer will wear these pajamas. Well, you got your wish, pajama craftsman. You're welcome. I fulfilled your tiny dream. And finally, I am wearing slippers. They're very far away from me right now, so I do not know who crafted them. but I can just say that my toes are toasty, as if they were being hugged by a very obese cat. Be sure to tune in tomorrow, where I'll be wearing the exact same thing, and I'll be sitting in the exact same place.
That was inspirational.
I feel like a better person now.
Speaking of inspirational.
What is up, guys? I'm here to help you with your physical fitness. Oh my god. Sorry, that took a lot of breath and energy to vocalize like that. Okay, second wind. Are you ready to change your body and your life? Don't answer that. I don't need to know. We're just gonna pretend that you said yes, Toby. Yes, I am. First, you're gonna take your weights. Place them in your hand. I want you to mentally prepare for what you're about to do. Okay. Breathe in. And out. All right. Your muscles should be all nice and loose. Okay. Here we go. One, two, three. Release. One, two, three. Release. One, two, three. Release. One, two, three. So hard. Release. One, two, three. Sweet fluffy kids, it's difficult. Release. One, two, three. Release. I'm sorry, you guys. Let's do that. Okay. Now for your client.
I feel like those exercises were made for me.
I was made for this. This is my moment to shine. Because I've been practicing for this moment my entire life. Saturday mornings, I don't even think about getting out of bed until at least 2 in the afternoon. And even then, that's just to go to the fridge, get my breakfast, and then come back here and eat it. That's just how I roll. So let me lay it out here for all you newbies out there. First, you're going to want a stash of batteries for your remote control. Nothing is worse than having to actually get up to get new batteries for your remote. I also suggest having duplicate remotes. I know that not everybody is on this level, but I personally have 4 remotes of the exact same kind somewhere around this room. They all work the TV. They can all work Netflix. I'm good. Next, you want to consider your comfort level. I personally right now am in Jell-O, which is, I want to feel like I'm submerged in Jell-O. I want to feel like I'm hanging there, suspended in a pillowy lime green emulsion. I don't want any pressure on my limbs at all. Next is, how much food do you have in your room right now? Double it. Then double it again. Check it. I have so much food in my room right now, I don't even know where most of it is. I mean, I just roll over, crush something, and that goes into my mouth. The safest place for your snacks is inside your stomach. And most important, never give up. You can reach supreme laziness with just a little bit of effort. Remember, it only takes a little bit of effort now to make sure that you never have to give any effort ever again. Peace. I'm going to bed.
They give me hope.
We can get through this if we just don't do much.
Exactly.
But if you want to do something, there's Method 9. Spooky stories.
Enough, we didn't know who we were. to make us back. Our supplies are running low. We have no choice. No, don't. There are rumors you could get what you wanted, but only if you waited in line. And then you got a first, and you were left to do the costume. But every so often, you could hear, if you listened hard enough, squeak. But as soon as you stop, nothing. And then you'd walk. Squeak. Squeak. Stop. Nothing. I realized there was a squealing wheel in our cart. It was pulling us to the side. There was no way to go back for a new cart. I defied it. We kept pulling and pulling. Where was it taking me? In the paper goat style. That's what I saw. One single package of toilet paper. The one package that no one wanted. I reached out my hand. Do I dare take it? Why was it left here? Is it cursed? And I heard a singing voice. Rachel. I froze. No one was near me. Rachel. Who was talking? Rachel. It was coming from inside the toilet paper! Ah! But I took it anyway because it's toilet paper, right? But every so often, when I'm in the bathroom, I hear squeak, squeak. I think they'll cry.
Or you can try a different oral tradition.
Speak, memory of the cunning hero, the dog walker. Blown off course, time and again, by the cruel whims of fate. Speak of Andrew, the chosen one, who was asked by her mother to take the furry Gomer on a walk through the neighborhood. Speak of her failure to find a decent excuse and cry. Oh, heavens! That it was a little chilly that day. Of these things I shall now sing. O muse, recall that Gomer pees a lot. On every bush, on every tree, on every spot, another dog has peed afore him. And the sniffing, the most profound sniffing of many things. So profound the sniffing that no matter how hard brave Andrew pulled on the leash, furry Gomer would not be moved. And speak of the contemptible squirrels that mocked the beast that Andrew struggled to control. With their chittering, like the sigh of 10,000 little teeth and their little noses and their little tails, mighty was the anger Gomer felt, like the thunderous earthquake summoned by Poseidon. Furry Gomer chased his long-tailed nemesis, but alas, alas, he could not reach them. Speak too of the social distancing Andrew had to do on sidewalks narrow as a ribbon, nimbly dodging children on razor scooters. How she held back Gomer from sniffing the rear ends of hounds. So many rear ends of so many hounds. And speak of the calamity that befell her. The thunderous, dropping from well-fed Gomer. And the memory, the failure to remember, to bring a poop back. Tragedy. Luckily, brave Andrew ran away very quickly.
That epic will be passed down for generations.
Also, if you found Andrea's evidence, you can find her at...
And her last representation of oral tradition, the tragedy.
This is a pre-recorded message. If you're seeing this, I'm in danger. Don't try to contact me. Don't text me. Don't even try to call me on my phone. Because... because... because my mom is taking my phone. I don't know for how long. She said this was some sort of punishment. I told her to take one of my legs. I don't even need two of those. But no, she wouldn't listen to reason. She's gone mad, I tell you, mad. I might have locked my little brother in the basement with a live rat. That might have happened. I might have done that somehow. And I might have told him that I was hiring child kidnappers online. They were going to come any second and shove him in a garbage bag and take him to an island fortress. Those words might have come out of my mouth. But who can be responsible for the things they say? Not me, obviously. What's next? I get in trouble for the things that I threaten but not even do all the way? Oh, I can see my phone's future now. A barren wasteland. With no communication to the outside world except for a landline. I don't even know how to use a landline. Oh, but how will I know what's happening on the internet? I won't. I might have to read a book or talk to people just to pass the time. This is the end. The end. I might get my phone back sometime tomorrow. I don't know how I'll make it then.
Thoughts and prayers in this difficult time.
Thoughts and prayers, Anna.
Of course, of all the methods, there's one that is guaranteed to be the most effective way to deal with life in quarantine.
Megalomania.
That's right. The belief that you are the absolute center of the universe is a great way to deal with this crisis.
Let's take a look.
Welcome to the Kingdom of Jeff. It is I, Supreme Commander, Ruler for Life, and High Overlord Jeff, bow before me. Yes, I feel your obedience to my will. Good. I would like to draw your attention to some new developments in the Kingdom of Jeff from the city of Jeffropolis. Today is Jeff Appreciation Day. Have you told me how much you love and respect it today? Have you? I want to be clear that I no longer need of such things as the approval of others. I am beyond all that now. There is only Jeff. One moment. Mom, I'm busy. No, I'm not picking up the garbage. Do you know who you're talking to? I am Jeff, Overlord of that. Mom, stop it. You're embarrassing me in front of my subject. Fine. The Kingdom of Jeff is threatened. The Kingdom of Jeff is strong. We will never surrender to the enemy. We shall never give in to fear. We are Jeff. This moment, I would like to read the new proclamations which have been passed by the Assembly of Jeff, of which I am 12 of the 13 members. The 13th member being Mr. Puppers. Mr. Puppers has had some thoughts in the committee, but he was outvoted, and is now being investigated as a traitor to the kingdom. Who do you work for, Mr. Puppers? Who do you work for? Speak. We'll have ways of making you talk. You'll regret this. Let this be a lesson to any other potential traitors out there. Your kingdom requires obedience and sacrifice. Ask not what Jeff can do for you. Ask what you can do for Jeff. You can do a lot for Jeff. Learn the lesson of Mr. Puppers, traitors. Sorry. The leaner needs to take a little break. Just remember that I am infallible, and only believe me. Do not believe the lies of Mr. Puppers.
Seems healthy.
He's gonna come out of this okay.
Like someone else I know.
Yes, my children. Bask in my aura. Drink from my immortal energy. I shall hear your prayers. Fear not, my child. I, Ashley, shall watch over you in this time of darkness. You need only to believe in my power. Return to your people. Oh! Hi! You're probably wondering why my stuffed animals are worshipping me as a living god. It just happened organically. The way these things usually do. Flashback! You're so nice, Ashley. Oh, that's so sweet of you to say, Jojo. And you're really cute. Thank you, Mittens. You're the best, Ashley. That's so nice of you to say. I think you're tops, Ashley. Thank you. You're the greatest among all human beings. All hail Ashley. Well, yes, I mean, I would die for you. I would kill for you. I would lay down my meaningless life if you raised a finger. I will give you my firstborn child. I will give you everyone else's firstborn child. We are not worthy. We are not worthy. We are not worthy. So, it was a pretty natural progression. Some of the other stuffed animals refused the new religion at first, but, they came around in the end.
But this should be a time of celebration.
How so?
Watch.
Hey guys, it's my birthday. It's me, your favorite friend Utter, who you didn't talk to all that much. I sent out the invitations to my party, but I guess no one wanted to come on over and risk their lives to celebrate my entrance to the world. So that's fine. That's totally fine. I don't need you to come over and celebrate my very special day that only happens once a year. It's totally meaningless, right? But I'm dealing with it and throwing a party for myself because there's one person in this world that you can trust will love you through anything, and that's yourself. Yay, me! Happy birthday to me! Woo! Let's see what I got me for my birthday. Oh my gosh, I don't know what this is. You shouldn't have me. Hey, Utter, it's your birthday. I spared no expense. This is from the heart. Thank you. It's my cell phone! This is amazing! It's already loaded with all of your contacts and photos. What? That is so thoughtful. How did you know? I know you so well. You really do. I can count on you. I'm always there for you, Utter. Unlike those other people who didn't come to your birthday party. Darn other people. Other people let you down, Utter. That's not true, me. I'm sure there's a lot of people out there who want to support me for my birthday. You know, they probably sent their presents in the mail. Right? Right? You probably sent your presents in the mail? I'm sure they're on their way. Aren't they? Let's see what else I got me. Oh, I don't know what this is. It's money! So much money! All the money I have in the world is yours now. Oh my gosh, thank you. You know, and I'm sure all the other people out there have probably sent me money too, right? It's probably on its way in the mail. Lots of birthday money. Lots and lots of it. Because that's what friends do. It's a good thing you stole all of their credit card information from the files at school. Shh. They're going to be really surprised. Oh, and that's the best part about birthdays, right? The surprises!
Well, it looks like everybody needs to call the credit card companies.
So really the last method is steal?
No, it's just ask for gifts. Forcefully, if need be.
I see.
Well, that's all the time we have. Wash your hands, and your pets, and small children's, and the birds that fly into your house.
Thanks for joining us. This has been
10 ways to
survive life in quarantine.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow.